Hey guys, for those of you who know me, know that I don't do vocal videos unless something is actually wrong. And believe me, something is actually wrong. So this guy named AUS or AUS or whatever his name is, believe it or not, that's Krattor, whatever. I mean, Krat comes back, does his little thing with server crashing, spawns golems and whatever everywhere. Then he vanishes. And not even 2 weeks later, this guy, using the exact same font as Krat, he uses friggin' the small transformations, he uses a tiny Carno, tiny Triceratops, just like Krattor. He speaks the same language as Krattor. He acts just like Krattor. He makes the same threats just like Krattor. This guy is clearly Krattor. Anyway, that's not the point though. So, what I'm making this video for is that this new version of Krattor is continuously coming after me, Liverpool, my boyfriend, and most of my other friends, because they think we're the ones crashing and freezing up servers. I know who's freezing servers up, and it ain't us. It's one of us, yeah, actually. You know the one that, I'm sure people have seen the black level 75 compy named Zero, the number Zero. Sorry for the coughing too, guys, I'm getting over a cold, I've been sick all week. But anyway, that black compy is more than capable of freezing up servers with fire. I don't know if she can freeze it up with bosses or not, but I know that she can use the fireballs. Anyway, since my boyfriend and I are usually around when she starts freezing up servers, this guy just immediately assumes that it's all of us doing it. But reality, the only reason she has ever frozen servers is because he would come around and start spamming a bunch of nonsense in the chat so nobody could talk. So she would freeze it to get him out, and then once he's gone, she would unlock it so people could rejoin and actually have a decent time. Another thing is the hero crashing. She hero crashes normal people who, again, spam nonsense in chat, keeping people from being able to talk to each other. And she also hero crashes abusive hackers who use hacks to kill other people or are spawning wyverns and crashing servers with them. Those are good reasons to hero crash. Now this guy has tried hero crashing me multiple times, even though I don't even hack anymore. Like, let's see, where was it? It was at 29, I believe. All of a sudden, almost everywhere I joined, the mini freezes and game crashes closing. I noticed the same names in the player list. Mr. Afton, my boyfriend, he can't actually crash servers. Like, the best he can get to crashing is spawning a meteor or two. Mrs. Afton, which is me, that's my normal account. Zero is the only one on this list that can actually crash. Amber YT, again, that's my one of my reg accounts, that's my black compy. Mrs. Afton is my white raptor, aloe. Liverpool can hero crash, but she's like me. She crashes people who abuse power and whatnot. And Springtrap, I don't know, like my boyfriend and I both use that name. So I don't think he's talking about me because I haven't used that account in what feels like forever. But I think my boyfriend recently used, I think it was Poison Springtrap or something? I don't know. But anyway, the only one on this list that's actually capable of freezing up servers is Zero. And she has decent reason to have to do so occasionally. He says everywhere he joins. So what he's saying is that Zero is everywhere at one time. Because that's just how Krattor's mind works. Anyway, I'm sure a lot of you have seen that. My boyfriend recently uploaded a video showing what AUS does. He left Kahlo and came back with a different name and then mass spawned a bunch of demons to try to lag everyone out. He lagged everyone out except for my boyfriend, oddly enough. But some people say that that video doesn't prove anything. Actually, what it proves is that we're not the ones mass spawning bosses everywhere. That's Krattor doing that. Anyway, this is before they even knew who I was. I haven't done anything or introduced myself yet. Actually, you continuously spammed garbage in the chat, and when you say you came back a week ago? He was literally he had a script that would automatically spam stuff in the chat. That's how he was spamming so quickly. And that was going on for at least 3 weeks. So, yeah, already this dude's a liar. Just a huge liar, just like Krattor. So after realizing I couldn't properly play the game, I started to take action and put them under my radar and track them down. Yeah, he's been following us around like a stalker for at least a couple weeks now. I started noticing it mostly, I think, a few days ago, but my boyfriend did bring it up to me quite some time before that, hey, this AUS guy seems to be everywhere that we are, and I didn't really think much about it, so I thought, it's just some guy who's just, you know, happened to be in the same place that we are, who cares? But then every time we server hop, this is the part that I noticed a few days ago, every time we server hop to go somewhere else to hang out, there's this AUS guy that joins right after we do. So, okay, this guy's stalking, and it's honestly really creepy. Like, dude, you can't get a girl. That's not our problem. You don't need to follow us everywhere. Anyway, once I found them in a room, I started to spam, insult them. Actually, you've been doing that long before. Like, Zero only recently, like, she's been fire crashing, or using fireballs, I should say, for maybe a month at best? And she's only ever frozen up servers like 3, maybe 4 times at most. So she's a very, very, very nice player. And she even told me, she froze up the server while this guy was in Kalos spamming his little chat script. And no matter how many times I tried to tell Zero to stop, I just couldn't get through to her because this guy was spamming. And the only reason she was closing the server in the first place is so nobody else would have to listen to this guy spam in the chat. So, again, she's trying to look out for players. This guy is just trying to ruin the game. Anyway, and so to get them to crash me. Yeah, no, Zero's the only one who could crash you, Krattor. The rest of us didn't have, like, a hero crash or anything. I'm a normal player. I don't hack anymore. So, I think the only time I can say I will willingly hack is when I want to make another troll video, like my last troll video, or I trolled some of my friends in a voice chat. That's the only time I will actually hack, but even at that, the only codes I will willingly use is, the immortality and maybe a couple animations or something. But aside from that, I could care less about freezing a server. Like, come on. I want to play normally, too. Just like everybody else. Anyway. Let's see. I have found various counters to their hero crashes. There's literally only one counter. And boss pop-ups, again, there's only one counter. And I also have both of them. And fixed them. I even mentioned to them I was the one responsible for spawning the golem. He never mentioned that. In fact, a lot of us can even say that we blamed him for mass spawning golems and demons. And then he goes and says, no, that's not me. And then just here, he mentioned that it was him. No. He tried denying it. Like, bruh. And I have actually multiple witnesses who can back me up on that, because a lot of us have blamed him and he said, no, wasn't him. Anyway. But that was only talking shit to them to get them to crash me. Yeah, no. They're the kind of individuals who keep scripts like this secret. Yeah, we keep scripts like this secret because we know what happens. I mean, look what happened to Dinos Online 2.2.1. The friggin' boss spamming script got out, and then there were snow queens everywhere lagging servers on a catastrophic level. That's what happens when stuff like this goes public. Nobody can play normally. So we keep scripts that are potentially game-breaking private, yeah, because the public doesn't know how to treat stuff like that properly. They will abuse, they'll do whatever the heck they want with them, they'll break the game, and there's no point. People just want to play normally. So yeah, people ask us, hey, can we have your script or can you give us this and this code? Of course we're gonna say no. Logical people that use scripts will say no. So they continue to have the privilege of crashing. Actually, the crashing, as far as I know, at least Zero's version of crashing isn't even in a script. She told me this, she just does it manually. I think the only script that she actually has is one that I made for her that has, like, animations and whatever in it. So whatever she does to crash, she does that on her own. She doesn't use scripts. So, and I decided to share their script that spawn and expose the old version they're in. We're actually in version 5.0.1. So, yeah, we're in the most updated version of the game. Let's see. Oh my god, this guy just writes novels. Why? Oh, come on. As 4.1, 4.1, the servers work on 5.0, and by showing how to hack in this old version and expose the spawn crash codes, the developers will identify. I shouldn't have to say that the developers don't give a rat's ass about their games. How many games have they made? And they've abandoned every single one of them. Yeah, they updated the game, but what did they change? What did they change? Granted, the Dilo actually has a mouth now, but that's literally it. Aside from the fact that people who use 5.0.1, who happen to be around when a boss is spawned and killed, the people who use 5.0.1 will crash from those bosses. Because of the stupid congratulation banner that pops up. So pretty much the developers are ruining their own game by crashing people themselves. Way to go, One Games. Developers, as soon as Dinos Online will go RIP, and as YouTube is a primary platform, One Games checks for hackers. No, they clearly don't. It's been... how many years has it been since they fixed the initial modder problem? Almost 2 years? They clearly don't check for hackers. There are a ton of Dinos Online hackers on YouTube. Not a single one, not a single hack code or anything has been patched. Not a single one. They changed the code around, that's about it. The code was not hard at all to crack. One of my best friends, Nightmare Sans, I'm sure a lot of you know him, was the very first hacker to crack said code. And he came in to being his awesome self, giving pose to people. He could ban people just by biting them. He could freeze people just by biting them. He could crash an entire server by spawning mass pets. It was crazy. That man is terrifying. I mean, he could even shut down all the friggin' Dinos Online servers. Just don't get on his bad side. I'm lucky that he's on our side. Anyway. Primary platform, they will eventually fix and shut off the old servers and the old versions or update the new one. 5.0.1 is just as hackable as all the older versions. I mean, my boyfriend managed to do it, and he's brainless when it comes to hacking. So the little scripts that have been crashing everyone in the game will cease to exist and become useless. No they won't, and literally the only thing that crashes people in the script that I made, which I don't even use anymore because it crashes people, is the, like I said earlier, the boss spawning. The bosses, it's not even the bosses that crash people, it's the banners that show up when you kill a boss. Like, Zero managed to get rid of her banners, so whenever she spawns a boss, The banners will show for her, but they won't show for anybody else. So, yeah. Let's see. Good lord. So the point of sharing the script is to be you, Krattor, to completely ruin the game like you've always wanted to do, we know. We'll enable the developers to fix things that they won't fix anything. Shut off the old servers and make this, whatever, move in the new version. We're already in the new version. Shutting off the old servers won't do anything against us. I mean, I'm not even a hacker. Spring, my boyfriend, he uses the new version. Zero uses the new version. Yeah. Anyway. Instead of more crashes, so instead of having his... I can't read this guy's English. This hackers keep the script secret and prolong the constant crashes in the game, you all have even more chaos, but in the end it's just gonna be for a shorter period of time. No, the developers won't just, hey look, this guy is destroying our game, we need to update it right here stat! That's not gonna happen, Krattor. You know that, of everybody. You just wanna be your old self and cause a ton of chaos. Fix things so no one will crash each other anymore. People will still crash, whether you believe it or not. Because even in the new version, bosses can still be spawned. Obviously, my boyfriend does it all the time. And he actually just recently learned that that's what's crashing people, is his boss. He wasn't at work right now. I'd have his head. Let's see, is this finally the end of this novel? So in the end, I ain't the bad guy. You're definitely the bad guy for wanting to ruin the game for literally everybody. And I ain't doing this to cause total chaos, you literally are. What I'm doing is getting rid of all kind of crashes altogether. There's literally only two crashes. Three. The hero, the boss banners, and then the occasional fire crash that Zero does whenever people like him act out. Yes, this is harsh and causes chaos, but in the end you'll be thanking me later. Play peacefully. Yeah, I'm sorry, but One Games, ever since the game Dinos Online first came out, what version was it? 1.0 point something. Yeah, I played that long ago. Back then, it was okay. I mean, it didn't take long for hackers to appear, because Unity games are not at all hard to hack. I mean, a monkey could do it. But anyway, it didn't take long for hackers to appear back then. So they continuously updated, not continuously, meaning every other year and a half. But anyway, they don't provide any patch notes, but I can almost see it, that they tried getting rid of hackers. Okay, 1.5 appeared. Mod menus and everything started appearing. Oh no, we gotta get rid of this. 2.0 appeared. Again, modders. Mod menus, whatever, appeared. Oh no, gotta get rid of these guys. Updated to 4.0. And now suddenly, Game Guardian scripters are here. Updated to 5.0. Still Game Guardian scripters are here. It doesn't matter how often they update their game. Hackers are going to do what they want to do. No matter what you say, Krattor. And I know that Nightmare Sands got rid of a lot of hackers. I'm not gonna name any names because I know some of them watch my videos, but he can get rid of you too, Krattor. I mean, I'm surprised he hasn't yet. Anyway, so Krattor plans on destroying the game as proven. Oh, Jesus. As proven here, I don't know what else to say. He blames literally only three people for his outburst, two of which aren't even capable of crashing. Or I'm sorry, four people: me, Liverpool, Zero, and my boyfriend. When only two, well, Liverpool can hero crash, she can't fire crash. Zero can do both. And then Spring and I can't do either. Obviously, I'm a normal player. Anyway. Like I said earlier, those of you who actually know us know that we're not the cause of this. Krattor has been this way for a very long time. He has come after me quite often. Started back in 1.5 when I made my very first personal mod. I don't think it was Reaper, I think it was someone else, but he and somebody else came after me and started fire crashing me because they didn't like my mod, and like, I don't remember what mod I was using at the time, but it was nothing special. It's just something that I wanted to make, and since I was a newbie back then, I didn't know how to make all this crashing and anti-crashing stuff. I didn't even know how to spawn bosses at the time. I just knew how to be immortal and how to be large. I didn't even know how to make a grade at the time. So anyway, this guy has been coming after me since way back then. So I'm not surprised that he'd be pulling something like this now. Yeah, his followers will call me a liar, but that's okay, I'm used to it. Anyway, now that y'all know what Krattor is truly up to, well, you can be prepared for his little script rant. Anyway, hope y'all have a good day.